हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी हैव विद अस डॉक्टर प्रशांत तांबे, डायरेक्टर फॉर ATES टेक्निकल कैंपस अकोले, ऑन अवर प्रोग्राम थॉट्स ऑन एजुकेशन बाय कॉलेज दुनिया. अ वार्म वेलकम टू यू सर ऑन अवर प्रोग्राम.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू हर्ष.
सो सर, स्टार्टिंग विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, यू हैव थ्रू आउट योर प्रोफेशनल करियर, सो व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स दैट केप्ट यू कनेक्टेड विद द एजुकेशन सेक्टर?
It is said that if you want to destroy a country, you didn't need bombs or army. If you will destroy their educational system, no, then that country will be destroyed. Okay. It was written on a university's entrance in Africa. And I think it has been said by Nelson Mandela. Just like to build a nation, educational system is much more important. And I feel that to build a nation, we should guide the students, the youth, so that they are having lots of talent, lots of ideas, and we have to channelize them. Because they don't know how to go far. So we should guide them, we should give suggestions to them, how to go on the right path.
Okay, so you want to make a difference to the society by being in the education sector.
I'm working in rural area only because it's my I think that in a rural area there is much more talent, and those people are not having the right guidance, right direction. So for that only we are working in a rural area.
Okay. So Akole has one of its branches in Akole, as well as one is there in Akola, the city Akola, and one is in Ahmednagar district.
Akola is a district place, which is in Vidarbha. Yeah. Yes. And Akole is a taluka in Ahmednagar district. Yeah. Okay. And it is famous for that Bhandardhara Dam, Wilson Dam.
Okay. So it like it might be also an attraction for the students studying in the institute to visit over there and spend their lovely time, like memories with the student, like create the memories along with their classmates.
Yes. So it's a good place. Means it's a tribal area, hilly area. During rainy season, the climate is so good that you can enjoy that.
Okay, the students might also go for trekking sometimes.
Yes. Every year, freshers party, we are organizing freshers party at Bhandardhara Dam only.
Okay, that's great to hear, sir.
Because in the month of August, admissions are completed, no? So that time, we give freshers party to students at that dam only.
Okay. So, sir, coming to the next question, being the director of ATES Technical Campus, what is your philosophy of leadership and how would you describe your personal leadership style?
I believe in participative leadership style, because if you are not considering all those people for taking decisions now, then it might work. And we people are working in teamwork should be there. Okay. And it also allows us to solve the problems or get assessment of in 360 degree. So everyone's contribution is much important for taking decisions.
Okay, so that's great to hear, sir, that you are open to all the suggestions. I think every leader has this, like should have this quality, being open to suggestions, so that the questions can be looked from the different perspective as well.
Yes.
And then different kind of solutions can be reached by going through the suggestions.
Yeah.
Yes. So coming to the next question, sir, being the director of ATES again, how do you strategize the key programs and marketing of your school?
See, I believe that your students are your brand ambassadors. Okay. And if you are making advertisement, you are displaying huge boards and all those advertisements, then it doesn't work. What matters, your students' mouth publicity. Your students are your brand ambassadors, and what they are saying, that matters. Because if you are giving lots of advertisements in newspapers or you are displaying hoardings and all those things, that doesn't work. what your students feel from inner side, that works. And what we are giving to students, that matters, and that is our advertisement.
Okay, sir, but there is a problem with mouth-to-mouth, like mouth publicity. The thing is, we don't, like we usually don't get to reach the other parts of the country, like reach to the different states and reach to the different regions in Maharashtra as well. So do you think that there should be at least some of the like digital presence or some marketing?
Yeah,
right, not the marketing, but at least the advertisements and the truth about the institute should be out there for the students to look after. And getting the college as their shortlisted colleges. Okay. Do you think it lies there somewhere?
Right now, digital media is the backbone of the advertisement. Because to reach each and every part of your country or globe, then you should have your digital advertisements or digital,
presence in general, not the marketing only, but the digital presence is necessary.
It's essential. Yeah.
Okay. So coming to the next question, sir, how does the curriculum of ATS Technical Campus ensure the best practice in the industry is followed?
So university is revising its syllabus every 3 years. Okay. And right now they are tuned up with the industry need. And we are not having, we can't change the syllabus. We have to follow syllabus which has been declared by university. Okay. And what we are doing, we are giving them some additional add-on certificate courses. We are running that. So communication skills, because where we are lacking in rural area, no, that additional courses we are
unable to provide.
Means personality development, communication skills. So short-term courses we are conducting here in addition to our university syllabus.
Okay, so sir, as you said, you don't have much area to work for, at least for the academic curriculum. So what extracurricular activities do you provide to the students since they are not let down by the university in general? So what are the extracurricular activities that college focuses on for the personality development of the students? Like, are there any programs conducted? Are there any fests?
I will share one activity which we have conducted. So, every year what we are doing, we are sending our last year, means before pandemic, weekly bazaar is there on Thursday. So what we have done, we have sent our students in the bazaar. We ask them, you visit to a stall and ask him that I will help you in selling your products and see how products are or how products are sell, what pain has to be taken by that seller, and you will learn simply learning theoretical things. It doesn't matter because in theory and practical there is a large difference. Okay, means theoretically you may be sound, you may score 95% or 75%, but actually if you are going to work on the field now, you are not able to give the results.
Give the results.
Yeah. So like those activities we are running every time.
Okay. Then, so I think this is one of the very few institutes might be doing such kind of activities.
Yeah. Because we are not having that much resources as urban areas are having now. So we are doing such practices. We are. We have conducted many fortnightly events on Saturday and Sunday. So students are participating on those events, and according to that, they are able to face the interviews. Or we are also conducting industrial visits. Every semester, we are having one industrial visit so that they can tune up with the industry. What is the need of industry and how industry is working?
Okay, so sir, can you give us some idea about the current placement scenario of the college, and also what are the partnerships that college is having or is planning to have with the industry, like some companies, so that they can give them, the students of your college can get the internship out there. So are there any partnership there, or can we see coming them in the future?
Yeah, in coming future, we will having that those type. But right now, we are having MOUs with three, four companies. for MCA students, we are having live projects to students. The students are working on some what do you call that? मतलब कि जैसे छोटे-छोटे modules होते हैं ना, those students are working on small module so that they can get hands-on experience. And for MBA students, we are not having tie-up with industry, but we are sending our students for placements in nearby institutes. Where campus interviews are drawn.
Okay, yeah. Okay, that's nice to hear, sir. So coming to the next question, I think everyone, if you have like, if you're talking to someone, this is the question everyone's mind will pop up for. So the question is, how is the institute dealing with the current COVID-19 pandemic, and how are you resolving the pandemic in your own way?
Okay, we are facing lots of problems because the whole world has been hit by the COVID pandemic. Okay, and here we are facing the problem of internet connectivity.
Internet.
Because our students are living in the hilly area, somewhere they are not able to get internet connectivity. So, and online classes we are conducting. Means when we are getting relaxation from the collector, no? That time we are conducting physical classes also, taking all the care of the students. So that's it's a tricky question, or we are facing problems regarding this COVID pandemic. But still, we are overcoming to that.
Okay, so sir, can you see the hostel facilities being developed in the coming future so that even if there is such kind of pandemic, the students can be in their hostel rooms and then can get to study from there, since the yes. College like has internet facility that are good enough, right?
Yeah, we are having internet facility, Wi-Fi connectivity is there, and in future we are going to construct our hostel also, so that students may not get hampered due to such crisis.
Okay. So coming to the next question, could you give us some insights about how the institute can be more welcoming to the students from different economic as well as different races? Economic background as well as races.
See, equality is the universal value, what we do believe, okay? So, we don't believe in casteism, or religion, or backward class, forward class, or according to economical background. So, we are not discriminating in all those things. So, we welcome students from all those categories, means any caste, any family background, any economical background.
Okay, so sir, are there any scholarships provided to the students who are not able to pay their fees since the for the courses, professional courses like BTech or MTech or MBA? And the course which is usually highest compared to the other courses, like non-professional courses?
See, for getting scholarship, no, there are some formalities on government level. So that student should have its caste validity, then income ceiling is there, okay. So if some students, those who have taken admission at our institute and they are not able to provide the caste validity, then we are not getting scholarship. When we didn't dismiss those students because of they are not getting scholarship, we have educated them on providing scholarship at our management level, at our institution level. So like that, I think till this year, I think 13 students we have educated like that. Means without taking a single rupee from them. Once they have admitted and scholarships, due to some technical reason, they didn't get scholarship, but we have not denied to educate them.
That's great to hear the college of such a level giving such facilities to the students, at least those who are not genuinely capable of giving the fees. So that's great to hear. So coming to the next question, what do you think are your roles and responsibilities to the institute and the students?
So today's scenario is that give and take. Okay. And regarding students, we are giving and giving only. Means it may be knowledge, it may be skill set, or it may be character building. Now it's students' turn to take opportunity take this opportunity and build their career and build their characters to build the nation and serve the nation. Okay.
Okay. So coming to the next question, this question might get you a little nostalgic, but going straight to the question, when you first came to the ATES technical campus, what was your vision for the institute and has it evolved over time? And the vision which you had, how far have you come in implementing those visions?
See, I was born in rural area, brought up in rural area, educated in the rural area, and I'm serving in rural area only. So since I got opportunity to work in Pune, but by choice, I have taken responsibility of this Akole Taluka Education Society's technical campus. So joining this institute, I was having some dreams in my mind. So firstly, I have told that I believe that there is a huge talent in rural area. Simply, we have to channelize them in a proper direction. We have to guide them. And here, first aim in my mind was that I will train those students and I will ask them to become entrepreneurs, not to become employees. Because doing MBA, everyone is thinking that I will get some handsome salary, I will work like this and that. But if everyone is thinking that I should get employment, then who is going to employ. Or provide employment? And here in rural area also, there is a lots of opportunity, there is ample potential for starting their own units or starting their own new ventures. It not may be in a bigger way, but it may be in small units also. It may be like what you call a dairy farm or
Students coming from students can come together and create a society that forces other people to be get inspired from them, and overall the rural area can develop as a whole.
Right. So last year we have started here incubation center also. We have taken some ideas from students also, and we can't believe that students are having different ideas. So one student has told us that regarding making cow dung, fertilizer from cow dung. Means if we want to make fertilizer from cow dung, no, we should wait for 6 to 8 months. But if you are starting that unit, no, within an hour, you can use that cow dung as a fertilizer and you can spread it in your farms. Yeah.
So that's great, sir. We feel more such potential is there in the rural areas, and the institutes like yours can give them the proper channel that is required for changing their dreams into the current ground level approach can be given using such institutes. So coming to the next question, what would you like to people to know about university that they may not know?
See, every institute is focusing on placement and placement only, but the basic motto of management institute is to make entrepreneurs, and that is our basic objective, that students from rural area should stay in rural area only and provide employment to others. And this is our main aim, and we are working on that only. So that I have told about that activity which we have conducted last year before pandemic. We have sent our students in the bazaar. Like such activities we are conducting every fortnightly or every weekly. So one activity has been taken by our faculty, Professor Gopal Bhu. What he has done, see, in a family, there is a dispute or there may be some misunderstanding between I can't talk with my father or I can't express my all views with my father. So what should be the solution? What he has done, one day he came into the class and he asked all the students, you write a letter to your father or mother and express all your views, which you can't say face to face. So some students ask them whether you are going to send this letter to our faculty, our parents or not. It's an activity. So many more students write the truth, which they were not able to express on face with their parents. And what he has done, he has posted all those letters to their parents. Some parents came to us and they cried. They told us that we are not able to think from those side of our students, of our words. Yeah, and that was the bridging of that gap. So such activities we are conducting here.
Okay, so it is, sir, it is like open my mind, like even today many of the students, be it rural or be it in the urban population, the student usually as they get older, they don't express their feelings to their parents.
Yes, yes.
Generally, so I think even the parents might be overwhelmed with this such kind of act.
Yeah.
So, sir, coming to the next question, what are some of the biggest challenges you see both for higher education and ATS Technical Campus in specific?
See, it's very simple that there is a gap between theory and practical, which we should bridge those gaps. And instead of going for theory only, we should be practical. And we should give practical knowledge to students. Because after all, getting a post-graduation degree or doing PhD and all other things, we should be a good good person in his life.
Personality development.
Yes, yes.
So, and, sir,
instead of giving theoretical education only, practical based education must be there.
So both are required, the theory as well as the practical solution, both are equally important.
And here, what challenges we are facing now, as we are situated in a tribal area, it's outskirt from the national highway, and we are facing challenges of resources. So, which we have to overcome on those resources. But right now, due to this digitalization, we are able to conduct online classes from expert faculties situated in Pune or Nasik or Mumbai.
So, I think, sir, the COVID-19 pandemic not only gave you the problems, but also gave you some of the new opportunities to connect with the senior authorities.
It has given a great lesson to we people that everyone was running behind the money, and everyone was flying. So this pandemic has given a lesson that you should be on the earth only, your folks must be on the earth only, because what is the family, everything, you can't purchase everything with money. Yeah, relations can't be purchased with the money. So that was the great lesson from. If you are going towards urbanization only, then there was a situation, some of the families which were not able to open their door of flat. Means they were in the flat only for 6 months, 7 months, yeah, a year also. But in rural area, everyone was getting outside.
Outside, yes, sir. Yeah. So, sir, being in a rural area, what are the challenges you face to upgrade the quality of education that you are providing to the students?
See, in rural area, now the students are shy; they are not able to express. So, first of all, we have to work on communication skills only, that they can express, because they are having that knowledge, that idea. And they are not able to face the interviews because of the communication problem only. and they are not having that habit to speak in English or to interact with those peoples. So that is the bigger challenge which can be overcome by giving them training. So our training and placement officer is working on that, what is need of industry. Accordingly, we are giving conducting those modules to train our students, so that after completing fourth semester, he may get some placement or he may start his own venture.
So I think you and the TPO sir are both working on the personality development of the student as a whole.
That is the demand of this situation.
Now that we can see there are much courses available online for the personality development, the soft skill development, can we see that ATS Technical Campus is associating with one of such vendors and then providing the students with such courses at lowest cost that is possible?
Yes, surely.
Can you see that coming in the immediate future, like in the coming 2 or 3 years, since coming there and teaching to the student the soft skills that are required is not possible? So I think the better option would be connect with such vendors and then provide the courses, degree courses or the certificate courses, we can say that.
Yes. Right now, some of the certification courses we have typed with, I'm not able to name that company, it's from Nagpur. So they are conducting such certificate courses of CRAC courses for 15 days or 10 days like that. So we are ready to type with such vendors, because we want to improve our students and make them employable.
Yes sir, last but not the least question. Any suggestion that you would like to give to the current youth and the aspiring students?
Students must be passionate towards their dreams, and they should focus on their passion, on their dreams only. Instead of, see what happens, if my friend is going to engineering, then even though I'm interested in music, I take admission for engineering, and after completing first year, second year, when my results are 2-3 subjects are down, then I feel that I have taken wrong decision. So instead of doing such things, they should be passionate, and if their dream should be big, and don't chase this success. Make yourself such strong, such competent that success will chase you. That's I want to say to my students.
And see, that's great.
Yeah. 3 lines I have written in my office, that people who change after change will survive. People who change with change will succeed. And people who cause for change will lead.
Indeed.
Yeah.
So that's great saying, sir. That's also very great advice to any young student or the aspiring youth. Sir, would you also like to give any other suggestions if you would like to add to what you just said?
See, it's my request to students, instead of going towards metropolitan cities, urban areas, just you visit for 2 years in rural area. See what are the problems. There are, every problem comes with solution and opportunity. Okay, so if you are going to study in such an area, then you can do miracles also. Because if you will go through the history, every person, every who is a scientist, great leaders, they are from rural background only. Because unless and until you are facing problems, you can't succeed or you can't become a strong person. मतलब जब तक आपके जिंदगी में मुश्किलें नहीं आएंगे तब तक आप स्ट्रांग नहीं बन पाओगे. आसानी से अगर
सामने करने के बाद
आसानी से अगर सब कुछ मिल जाता है तो आदमी मतलब कैसा, वो थोड़ा सा क्या बोलते हैं, सिक्योर्ड फील करने लगता है.
अनसिक्योर्ड
कंफर्ट में रहना तो ये नहीं.
The sense of insecurity in life to a small extent is very important. One of the great lines I had somewhere heard in the last week. सो मतलब उससे मैं रिलेट कर सकता हूँ ये सुन के सर. थैंक यू सो मच सर, आप हमारे इस प्रोग्राम के लिए आए, आपने इतना अच्छा कोऑर्डिनेशन किया हमारे साथ और इतने छोटे नोटिस पे आप अवेलेबल हुए हमारे लिए. सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर दैट.
तो इट वाज माय प्लेजर. और ये आपकी भी ये है कि हम लोग को मतलब आप डिजिटल डिजिटल एरिया में लेके जा रहे हो, मतलब बहुत सारे लोग भी हमें जान पाएंगे कि भाई यहाँ पे भी कुछ अच्छा हो रहा है कर. ठीक है, थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग अस अपॉर्चुनिटी. थैंक यू.